The Perseids meteor shower is an annual event that occurs from mid-July to late August, with its peak typically happening around August 12th to 13th. It is one of the best meteor showers to view because of its consistency and extended period of time in which it occurs. During this time, Earth passes through the debris left by the comet known as Swift Tuttle. As these small particles enter the atmosphere, they burn up and create bright streaks across the sky. And these happen at a regular period. So in this video, we'll discuss why meteor showers occur, get practice identifying the constellation Perseus, and some tips and tricks to help you view this meteor shower. Welcome to Learn the Sky. My name is Janine, and I'll be your guide as we explore the night sky one constellation at a time. First, let's take a closer look at the comet known as Swift Tuttle, since this is the comet that is associated with the Perseids. It was first independently discovered by astronomers Lewis Swift and Horace Tuttle in 1862. It is a periodic comet, meaning that it orbits the sun and returns to the inner solar system at regular intervals. The orbital path of Swift Tuttle is an elongated ellipse, which means it takes an extended journey throughout the solar system. Its last closest approach to the sun was in 1992, and it won't return until its next perihelion in 2125. As a comet approaches the sun, it starts to feel the effects of a gravitational pull, causing it to accelerate and gain speed. This increased speed is due to the sun's influence on the comet's motion, and as the comet gets closer to the sun, the solar radiation heats up the comet, causing its icy nucleus to release gas and dust, and this forms a glowing coma and a tail that points away from the sun. Once the comet has passed its perihelion and starts moving away from the sun, it begins to slow down again due to the sun's gravitational pull being less since it's farther away. As the comet moves away from the sun, its tail diminishes and it retreats back into the outer reaches of the solar system. Now let's review exactly what a meteor is. A meteor is a bright, glowing streak of light that occurs when a small object, often the size of a dust particle, enters the atmosphere at a high speed and burns up and glows due to friction and compression. This glowing trail of light right here is what we observe as a meteor, or sometimes they're called shooting stars. Now here's another great example of a meteor that you can see traveling through the Earth's atmosphere. This photograph was taken from the International Space Station, and it happens to be during the Perseids meteor shower. So what is the difference between a meteor and a meteorite and a shooting star? It depends on where the location of the dust and debris is. First, we start with meteoroids, and this is dust or debris that's located in space. As it enters the atmosphere, it burns up, that's a meteor, and if it hits the ground, it becomes a meteorite. Meteor showers are celestial events that happen that we observe from Earth, and this is when the Earth passes through lots of cosmic dust and debris that can be left over by comets or asteroids. And the appearance of a meteor can be very brief, lasting only a fraction of a second, or sometimes it can be more prolonged. And meteor showers are named after the place they appear to originate from the sky. So let's take a look at a different picture for this. As you look at this photo, this is a photograph that has been taken over the course of a meteor shower, so over many hours. And if you take these streaks of light and all trace them back to their origin point, this is what is called the radiant. And all meteor showers are named after the place at which they appear to originate from the sky. So for example, the Perseids meteor shower appears to originate in this area of Perseus. This radiant point is caused by the effect of perspective, which is very similar to parallel railroad tracks that are converging at a single vanishing point on the horizon when you view it from the middle of the tracks. This is very similar with meteor showers. The particles in a meteor shower are all traveling in parallel paths, and at the same velocity, so they will all appear to an observer who is photographing them to radiate from a single point. And meteor showers are almost always named after the constellation from which the meteors appear to originate. So if you look at this photograph, this is a 4-hour time lapse of a meteor shower. And if you trace all these points back to its origin point, this is where the radius would be. And remember, when you're viewing meteor showers, you're not going to notice this radiant effect. It's really only when you're photographing the meteors, they are just going to randomly appear in the sky. And it happens so quickly, only a fraction of a second. So you can almost blink and miss a meteor. So I hope that when you go out to see the Perseids, that you have clear skies, because that matters as well. If you have a cloudy sky or inclement weather or even a bright moon, chances are you're not going to see some of the meteors that are present. In the last portion of this video, let's learn a little bit more about the Perseus constellation. I do have an entire video about this constellation, so if you want to know more about it in detail, be sure to go see that video. But for now, we're just going to do a broad overview. So Perseus is best seen in the autumn and winter months in the northern hemisphere. However, when you're going out to see the Perseids, you're going to want to go out early in the morning, and you can see it during that time. And the key, if I back up here, if you're just looking at this picture, you should start to notice some star clusters that are in here, right there and right there. And these are the star clusters you want to look for. You can't see the Pleiades here, but the Pleiades is also nearby and close to Perseus, and that can be used as a marker to help you navigate your way towards this constellation. So let's get some more practice. Here is a picture, and I want you to notice a few things. First, you're going to notice my eye is drawn to this cluster, and this is called the double-double cluster because there are two star clusters that are very close together. They almost look like a pair of eyes to me. And then right down here, this is the Pleiades. This is a very easy to recognize star cluster that's in the constellation of Taurus. I have multiple videos about that star cluster, so go see those videos if you want to learn more. And then right here, this is also a star cluster. So you want to look for these areas in the sky. And of course, seeking out dark skies is best for when you want to find Perseus, and especially when you want to see a meteor shower. Here's the star pattern of Perseus traced onto the sky. Notice this is Perseus, his head, this is his arm, his body, and his legs down here. So let's look at another picture and see if you're able to point out some of those star clusters. For me, I noticed the Pleiades right down here. I do see the double-double cluster, and this is the Alpha Persei star cluster. So those are the areas you want to look for. And Perseus has a variety of shapes, depending on which resource you consult. This variation of the constellation I took from the International Astronomical Union, and you can see it somewhat represents what it looks like. Many of my students say it looks like Patrick from SpongeBob. I totally see that as well. But some of the other objects that are in this photo include Cassiopeia, which you can use as a guide to help you find Perseus. Andromeda is down here, and notice I highlighted the Andromeda Galaxy. So if you are able to ever see the Andromeda Galaxy, it's some of the oldest light you will see with the naked eye. It takes a very long time for that light to reach us. And then down here you have the Pleiades, and this bright star is Capella. Let's take a look at one more photo just to make sure you're well acquainted with how to find Perseus in the night sky. Remember, the best time to see the Perseids meteor shower is in the early morning hours. That's when you're going to see this constellation. And the meteors will come from all areas of the sky, but it's nice to at least know where its radiant is and where they appear to originate from. So here is the official star pattern of Perseus traced onto the sky. And you can see this was taken during the Perseids, because if you trace these meteors back, this is where the radiant is for the Perseids meteor shower. I also noticed the Pleiades star cluster, which is in the constellation of Taurus. This bright star is called Capella, and it's part of the constellation known as Auriga. And then here is Triangulum constellation. That's another marker you can use to help you find Perseus, and this is a part of Aries. So I wish you luck when trying to find the Perseid meteor shower. Now you know why we see these meteor showers, how they're named, and for this Perseid shower, how to find the constellation Perseus. Remember, it takes time, patience, and practice to stargaze and view a celestial event. So I hope the weather is on your side and you have cloud-free skies. Let me know in the comments below if you're able to see this meteor shower, or if you've at least seen it in the past. I know it's one of the best ones of the year. And the moon phase for 2020 should be pretty faint during the peak of the Perseids. So thank you so much for watching. And as always, keep looking up.